Well, howdy, 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 folks. I'm glad to be here. Jason got back in the nick of time, and so I'm sorry we're a little late. That was my fault. I do want to show you something. I don't know if I've shared this with you before, but how do you like that sexy Ben's cart sign? Jason sent that to me, and I got another one that's real long. It says Hot Dog Cart Store. This is just sexy, and I wanted to share that with you and let you see it. That's made out of license plates, right?
What is that?
Jason, that's made out of license plates?
Yeah, it's made out of license.
Boy, you don't have signal. Anyway, if you can hear me, Jason.
To sign back in a second.
All right. He'll be back in a minute, folks. I'm glad you're here. This is episode, I believe, 164. It is 164. And I have show notes here. And I want to congratulate the vendor of the week this week is Frankly Delicious. Frankly Delicious is, I like that name, Frankly. You get it? Play on words, Frank. So Frankly Delicious, vendor of the week. Let me tell you a little about them. It says, Well, Ben, we finally did it. After 2 years of slinging weekends and recently trying miserably to find a decent day spot, we lucked out. First day at the location last week scored $280 in 3 hours. Hoping to better that today. Hot dogs did save my life, and you can find them at facebook.com/ Frankly Delicious LLC. Okay, Frankly Delicious LLC. And so congratulations, Frankly Delicious. And thank you for being the vendor of the week. Hopefully there's a picture. I'm trying to get a picture posted up for you of the cute little girl in front of the cart holding the canned drinks up, and they've got a gorgeous sign, hot dogs. It's real big, has a big hot dog at the bottom of it. So there is no guessing what they're offering from a distance. And I like that. It's smart marketing. Their signs look good. The whole setup looks good. So I love it. So hopefully that'll be in the comments below. I'm not positive if it'll go in there. Now, Jason left again. Jason's having internet troubles. All right. So question from Ryan. Question from Ryan. I set up for my first day, made a deal with a pawn shop to feed their employees, and they will let me set up at any time I want. I set up on Monday from 11 to 3. I started with $40 for change and left with $102 in sales. It's right on the busiest route in Lexington. That was a tongue twister for me. Lexington, Kentucky. It's car traffic though, not foot traffic. Any ideas that could help bring in more money? So Jason, he's busy, busy street. And I don't have like an area map. I haven't been given an address to see where he is, but I'd like to know, is it easy to get in and out from his spot? Any ideas that could help bring in more money or more traffic, basically, which would solve that, right? So, this is about stopping moving customers, which is, it's one of the hardest things to do in this business is when you're on a busy road. I started off on a busy road and I learned tricks. And I don't know if y'all, if you remember, but the years ago, I'm talking even before me, like way before me, there were these signs, they called them bandit signs, and they'd put them out. And they used to have one for a shaving cream. And you'd see it basically say something cute, but it was one or two words at a time as you drove. But it helped you know when to pull in to the restaurant or whatever it was going to be. So what my first suggestion, because I can't see your location, is to put out signs that you remove each day so that you don't get, in trouble with putting them out there, that let people know that you're coming. That, and I would not try to tell them everything. Don't put your company name because that's immaterial. You want to put hot dogs. And then the next sign could be $4 value meal or whatever it is, right? All beef, next right. And as long as they see that in time, you will get more business. Another good thing is, if the picture went up, is of the vendor of the week, Frankly Delicious. Something big like that catches people's eyes. A swooper flag is one of my favorites too. It catches people's eyes. They're like, what is that? And but they don't have to guess. They don't have to wonder what you are. Here's my suggestion for you, Ryan, is I have a some cart critiques where vendors have submitted me pictures, maps of their cart. The most recent one was a problem with a vendor trying to stop moving traffic. And so we tried different things there. Okay. And I show you on a map on Google Earth, showed you where he put signs, how he set it up. And that may give you some ideas for pulling in stop traffic. It's kind of tricky sometimes to do that, but you can, you definitely can do it. I'm going to check on Jason here real quick. Is it working now?
I think so. Keep fading.
Yeah, it's it. You're still choppy.
Yeah, but I'm. What's the stuff you're saying?
The next question is Sam's Club hot dogs. It's the members, you know, members brand, the beef hot dogs. Any reviews? Well, if you had my book, you'd know it was my number one choice because it's made by Nathan's, from what we gathered. Okay, the intelligence we could gather. It was made by Nathan's. It's an all beef dog. It's an 8-to-1, which means 8 dogs to a pound. It is a delicious hot dog. Not a whole ton of flavor, but you can jack them up. So you can add stuff to your water. You can add garlic. You can add a beer into the water. And basically, you're super saturating the water so that when they taste it, they're tasting your brand of hot dog. Doesn't really matter what kind you put in there at that point. But I would say absolutely yes. Right now, they're about $20 for a case of 80 dogs for $20. Not bad. Okay. So check that out. Try them. Do the taste test. You know, if you had my book, my course book, I teach you how to do a taste test but I will say this, the Baker's and Chef dog, or Baker's brand now, it's a good dog and it will fit about anything. Just add some flavoring to it. We got people that put garlic cloves in it. We got people that put a little bit of cayenne pepper in the water, and some garlic and some salt. You can jack up your water flavor and it will help keep a hot dog from the water from saturating out the flavors from the dog. This way the water's already saturated with flavors. It'll just make the dogs taste better. Another trick tip that you can do is if you are using chlorinated water, boil it off first. Let it boil for a while. That'll boil out the chlorine and it won't turn your dogs white or, you know, that crappy pinkish yuck look. Okay. Anthony says he uses, I use roasted beef base in my water. That's another great one. Beef bouillon cubes. I know people that use the chicken cubes, chicken bouillon. So yeah, definitely. There's a lot of different things you can use. Now this, next question real quick. Let's see. I don't know if we can get this picture up. If we can, it'll be in the comments. But this is a picture of a wrecked, pretty bad hot dog cart. Like somebody rear-ended them or side-swiped them, it looks like, because it bent it up pretty bad. This person wants to know, this cart was in a wreck. The frame is good. It's mostly cosmetic on that one side. Can it be fixed? Thanks for your time and all you do. You're absolutely welcome. Yes, that cart can be fixed. Most anything can be repaired and it's better than starting over. Okay. You'll probably have to build a new frame from the picture I'm seeing around the steam table so that you get the right measurements so your pans fit snugly. okay? You'll probably have to do a couple other little things, but those panels, the sides of your cart, that stainless steel that's used there, you can get that at a sheet metal shop. You can go to the sheet metal or any steel fabrication shop. They can cut it and match it all back up, and it will be just like a brand new cart. So I would not trash that. In a second, I wouldn't trash that. I would be on that, and you'll save a ton of money. And when you're done, you'll have a nice cart. And even if it bent some of the framing underneath that's the structure part, not the frame for the trailer, but the structure, that can be straightened out. So it doesn't take that long. It's not like it's a car that, you know, where they're going to charge you $40,000. This is something you could strip the whole thing. They could straighten the top frame, get it square, and add your panels, put your used panels back on, and put your crushed up panels as new ones. You'll save a ton of money. I don't know what you paid for it, but you probably have $1,500 to $2,000 sitting there the way it is, just in stainless steel. So I'd say, and I don't know who makes that cart, but it's a nice looking cart. Looks good. Next one. Has anyone ever tried a mall parking lot? A mall parking lot. Yes, lots of people have tried mall parking lots. We got vendors in them now. Some of them, I even have a cart critique in a mall parking lot. A guy submitted his video and stuff, or his pictures, and I did the critique based on his mall because he wanted to find out where should he be set up, but he only had certain locations he could set up. So we moved him around and then rearranged his signage and got him all the traffic he needed. So you can definitely do good in a mall parking lot. As long as you got permission to be there, okay, for obvious reasons. But as long as you have permission, have at it, okay? I think malls are great places to be. Let me tell you this real quick, and then I'm going to go through your comments real quick and then answer any questions or read any of your comments. Look, Frankenstein's, I do the outer outlet mall here during Christmas, big moneymaker. Excellent. Frankenstein's, thanks for sharing that. And he's not in a huge city. And he does good. He's staying busier than he probably wishes he was. So here's what I want to tell you about. I am writing a brand new course book. Okay. That has more information in it. It's going to have more tips, more tricks, more hacks, more everything. Okay. And a lot more detail. So that everything won't fit everybody. So I have to put a lot more in there so that everybody can get what they need out of it. Right. Well, I'm going to give it to you. Here's how you get it. There's a link, and hopefully, if Heather is here, hopefully she can post that up for me. If not, she is here. The link, she just put it up. If you go to that link, you're going into even though you're already on my email list, this is a separate list just for this. Okay. I'm going to send you a chapter every time I finish one. So as I finish a chapter, I'm going to send it to you. Okay. And you can follow along. I'd love to get your feedback, but there's no catch, no gimmicks, no nothing behind it. I'm giving it to you. So if you signed up today, you're going to get all of it. If you sign up 2 weeks from now, you'll probably miss a couple chapters. But the bottom line is it's available to you because you're listening here now. So I hope that you'll take advantage of it. I'm going to put a lot of detail in it. If you see something you don't like or you disagree with, let me know. Okay. I'd love your feedback. Or if you have an idea, I may add it into it. I may go back before I go to print and add it in there. So, I thank you for the opportunity, and I look forward to doing this. I've been asked to do this for about 4 years now. People have asked, Ben, when are you going to do another book? When are you going to update the book? So I'm updating it. It's going to be a lot bigger. I can promise. I was just writing notes and stuff, and I was going, holy moly, because your knowledge increases over time. And then you combine that with what you learn with other vendors, because of my relationship with other vendors, I've learned a ton too. So, and I continually learn. So what happens is, Ryan, the link is about four posts below you. If you don't see it, it will, at the end of the show, we'll pin it to the top of the comments. So at the end of the show, we can pin it and then you'll see it the whole time. It may be able to be pinned now. I'm not sure how that works. So if you want that, get that. Now I want to go through this real quick and see, thank y'all for being here. Cheryl's here. I hadn't seen Cheryl for a while. Cheryl, glad you're here. Robbie's in the house. Robbie with Crazy Dogs, John Russell, David, Robbie Miller, Chef Jose. Let's see. Holy cow, a bunch of y'all here. Kevin, Pam, Jeff. Let's see. Robbie put the signs 3 miles up from the site, then 2 miles, then a mile, then 100 yards. Great advice, Robbie. Great advice. If you have the space to do that, okay. If it's slower traffic, you wouldn't have to go out so far. So, but if it's 60 mile an hour traffic, you want it 3 miles up, 2 miles up, 1 mile up, and then right before, you know, 100 yards. That way they got time to lock up the brakes, pull the e-brake, and slide in, right? Jimmy's Hot Dog says, good vending to all doggers. All right. There's Jimmy. Warren Russell, seen those free, yeah, seen those free beer next exit signs. That's it. Put what you offer on the signs, Ryan. Great advice, Robbie. Look at there. Frankenstein says, I run Members Mark and everyone loves it. I'm telling you that it's a good hot dog. It's my go-to for years. It's the hot dog I use. Liquid smoke, Jeff says, to add to your water. Remember we were talking about the dirty water? Great suggestion. My Facebook lagged and I missed everything up to this point. Ryan, hopefully it recorded it, as far as I never know till the end of it. And you can go back and watch. Look at there. Frankenstein says, put some celery salt in it. That's one of my favorite ones. I love celery salt. I like to have celery salt on the cart, even though I don't do Chicago dogs. Celery salt is the bomb. So use some of that. Jose's giving us an update here. Let me read this update. I'm not working 85 gazillion hours no more. Got a new chef job and more free time to build a cart. Awesome. Thanks to my flea market location, I've been able to work less hours and make more money vending. Jason, your dream will come true. The next time I send an update will be full-time vendor with new cart. Also, my business name will be Mighty Diggity Dogs and Catering. I'm so excited. If y'all don't know who Chef Jose is, you can search right here on this page for Chef Jose, or you can go over to the blog at learnhotdogs.com and search him there. You'll see the videos that he has sent in, given updates. He started with no cart. First weekend made a little over 500. Next weekend I'm not saying working all weekend. I'm saying working a Sunday, his only day off at the time. Then I think 1,100, and then something crazy the next time. It was over 2,000, I believe. He may have to correct me if I'm wrong, but I think it was over 2,000 on the next weekend. With a little grill, lemonade, and I think a crock pot or something. But bottom line is, can you start vending with little to no money? Absolutely, you can. I've been beating this drum for a long time. So if you're thinking about getting started, not sure if you can do it, can't afford a cart yet, why not you do what Chef Jose did? Why not you do what Cheryl's right here tonight. Ask her what she did. Two crock pots, a table. We got pictures of proof of it. And within 3 weeks, she had a cart. So, and she just bought a used cart, and that's the way to go. So I think you, if you want in this business, there's a link I'm going to give you real quick. You may have to remember it. learnhotdogs.com/now. I think that's the one. That'll give you, if you want to find out how to be an instant vendor without spending $2,000 or $1,000 or $3,000 or $5,000, you can do it. Look at there. Robbie Miller is talking about Snap Dogs. Now, if you're in the Vendors United group, I think we're going to have the president of and the owner of Snap Dogs on our show Monday night in the Vendors United. We're going to have an offer for our members there. Robbie has been kicking butt. Robbie and Tammy have been kicking butt with Snap Dogs. They've gotten publicity for it. They've gotten all kinds of media attention because it's a delicious hot dog. So they don't change color, he says, in the water or anything. So that's cool. Corey says, congratulations, Chef Jose. Matt Gladfelder's in the house. Matt has Bow Ties and Hot Dogs. Y'all need to check him out. Bow Ties and Hot Dogs, I think it's now changed to, Matt, you may kick me in the butt on this one, but I think it's now Bow Tie Food Truck. But anyway, you can still look up Bow Ties and Hot Dogs online and find him. Let's see. Ben in comments on the wrecked cart, he mentioned he also has a bent axle. Replaceable, Craig. You can replace the axle. I would definitely fix that cart. Even if I had to cut the body off the frame, I'd go get me another frame for $250 from Harbor Freight or Northern Tool and have somebody weld plates on it at a welding shop with holes in it so I could bolt it to my new trailer. And I wouldn't dare throw that away. I'm not saying that's what you were saying. I'm saying even with a bent axle, easy solution. Way better than buying another cart. And I bet you that cart was a $5,000-$6,000 cart. So when it was new. Thanks for letting me know, though, Craig. Let's see. I'm looking. Yeah, there. Matt just answered it for me. Craig, axles are easy to replace 110 minutes. In fact, if you were in the Vendors United group, Matt actually did it and filmed it for us. He had to replace his axle, and he did it and showed us all, you know, as he did it. There you go. Robbie says, take the axle, do the old Tennessee pull, hook it up to a tree, chain the truck and pull lightly and beat it out with a hammer. You can, but I actually took an axle to an old Land Cruiser FJ40 and that was bent. Okay. And it was one of them old timey straight axles. And I went and took it to a machine shop and they put it on a lathe, a huge steel lathe. Okay. And they heated and bent it back into shape. Never had another problem with it. How would a cart on a boat in the water do? Bridget Penny, they do awesome. We've interviewed vendors doing it. We've got video of it on the blog. We've got articles on it. If you just type in boat or pontoon, you're going to pull it up at learnhotdogs.com. It is phenomenal. We've got vendors. We got an older couple that's on, and I never get this right. It's not Michigan Lake, I think, or it's not Lake Michigan. It's Michigan Lake. It's one or the other. Older couple, they work through the summer on their pontoon, two carts on it, and they don't work the rest of the year. Okay. We've got over there near Frankenstein's. There's a vendor it's actually closer to Asheville or Black Mountain, but up on that lake, we got a vendor there with, I believe she has now two boats, I think, with carts on them. Yeah, Frankenstein says it would do awesome. If you can get on the water, you can do good. Hooked up an event at Jaghead Brewery next Friday night. Watch for Lighted Up Crazy Dogs. That's right. Robbie goes live a lot, him and Tammy. So you need to pay attention to those if you want to follow them. Crazy Dogs. Crazy Dogs. Just checking in. Have to go through. It's time to run the big truck down the road. Denver, thanks for being here, brother. Glad you're here. Yeah, we do have a United members vendor on a lake in the group. We do, Jeff. What cart would be a good one to start? I think we have two. What cart would be a good one to start with? I'm in the podunk town you started in, and I'm going to work all the shows and parking lots wherever I can get a permit and permission to sail. The simple, start with the cheapest cart you can find. If it's used, go to used. Go to learnhotdogs.com/used. Look at the used cart. See if there's any close to you. Look on Craigslist. Next, go. I would start with a cash cow and just go that route. You want to start as low as possible so that it pays off quick. Always do that, even if it's used or you build your own or whatever. Okay. Spend as least amount as possible and let it be what buys your next one. Okay. Matt Gladfelder didn't start out with, you know, a state of the art machine, and Corey Lawrence built his. A lot of people build them, you know, and then go from there. We've got the build a cart course. That's another good way to do if you got time to build and build it. It'd take you about a week if you did it full time, and about 2 weeks if you don't have enough time to do it. Thanks, Frank. Thinking about doing this. My town has a big turnout of fishers and vacationers. Bridget, I'll give you a tip real quick on that. Even if you can't get on the lake, you can be at the boat ramp or wherever people gather. I've done fishing tournaments and all kinds of stuff at the lake. I've been at Douglas Lake. Douglas Lake is huge, and so it's got all these spider things, so there's lots of different boat landings. But you find the busy ones, pull up. Nobody even question you because they think you're just supposed to be there. You just showed up with a hot dog cart and threw up your umbrella and flags, and you just start vending. And at a summertime on the lake, holy moly, people are like, oh my gosh, there's food here. I don't have to eat this, you know, grocery store. What are those that look like a triangle sandwich in a plastic thing? Let's see. Is there anyone who possibly has a template for contacting local businesses regarding sitting at their location? Some people have told me to send an email and so. Stephanie, never, never, never. I actually teach this in my free training. If you go to the blog at learnhotdogs.com, okay, I actually give you exactly what to do. But never send an email, okay? Never call them. Go in person. It is hard for somebody to say no. Why do you think religious groups come to your door instead of just send you an email to invite you to church? Why do you think that real good sales is in your face? You're not really selling. You want to convince them that you're doing them a favor. Here's the script I use real quick. Okay, Stephanie, I hope this helps you. Is I would go up to them and go, hey, my husband and I are doing a hot dog and catering cart, and we're just coming into this part of town. I've got a free lunch time available next Thursday. How would you like it if we came and set up and served your customers? We're fully licensed, insured, and we won't charge you a thing. Now, do you see how I did that? I didn't say, hey, can I park out in your parking lot? I'd really like to get some of your customers over to me. I'm being facetious, but I've had vendors do that or call on the phone. Hey, I got Hillbilly Hot Dogs and we're wanting to start vending. I saw you had a big parking lot and you look real busy. You can't do it that way. You need to go up to them, have a picture. Even if you don't have your cart yet, have a picture of a cart. Okay. Have something in your hand, a flyer, make a flyer with your WordPress, you know, with your Word, Microsoft Word, or, you know, and make you a little flyer and walk in there and go, hey, my name's Ben, you know, but use your name instead of mine, because it'll sound funny, Stephanie, if you use mine. Handyman Hot Dogs is in the house. Sent me to your old book. It may have like after, if you enter your email to get that, to get the free book, I haven't released it yet. So basically you're going to get it. You're going to get an email. If you put your email in there, it ain't going to tell you that you completed it. It'll just take you to another page, and they may have set it up to go to the page of the old book, but either way, or the current book, it's not old yet. All right. So, they will, I'm going to send you an email. Every time I finish a chapter, you'll get it. Period. But only the people on this list. Okay. That's it. Let's see. Good tip. Thank you, Ryan. Gary's here. Gary Batten with Dog Works. Anthony, the big dog kit, kind of do it all cart. Yeah. Matt's right. The big dog, is a do it all cart. It's a good all around cart to use. Let's see. I'm just making sure I don't miss anybody. Get the largest cart you can afford. It's better to have one that's bigger than what you need. Anthony's right. Hey, Ben, how many hot dogs would you stick in an event with 80,000 people? There will be other vendors. I don't know how many. Got to know that stuff, Dale. I actually have an outline on the blog. It's free. Okay. It'll tell you all the things you must know before you risk going to an event. Events are risky. You don't want to risk too much, right? You only want to risk what you can afford to risk. And a lot of people may be watching this going, oh man, I didn't know you could risk. Well, yeah. Well, if you buy 5,000 hot dogs and have nowhere to store them afterwards, and you get there and there's 11 million other vendors doing hot dogs, or they set you next to the porta potties. Okay. So you want to know certain things before you go. I have a list of those things to know. If you just search events at the blog, it'll give it to you. It's kind of long, but it'll protect you, Dale. It's a good question, though. Does anyone try the calorie dog, romaine leaf lettuce for a bun? Oh, a low calorie dog, like a low carb dog. That's a good question. Aaron asked. I'm sure it's been done. I haven't seen it. I don't think. I'm getting older, so my memory, okay? I don't think I've ever seen a lettuce-wrapped dog, but I like that idea. I think that's cool. I mean, Hardee's did good with their low-carb, back when the carb craze was going on. They did you could buy a whole burger and everything was wrapped in lettuce instead of a bun. Yeah, Frankenstein's is right. Take as much as you can, Dale, but you still want to know some stuff. I'd never go without knowing these certain things. Never. Let's see. Snap dogs are awesome, James Jones says. Let's see. Do I have to be a vendor to join Vendors United? No. Yancey, you do not have to be a vendor to join Vendors United. We've got about somewhere around 12 or 13 people in there not vending yet. They're just getting started or getting the information to get started. You just get a lot of help there at Vendors United. If you're interested in joining, that's learnhotdogs.com/join is the direct link. You can watch the video. Some sexy ball-headed guy from Tennessee is in the video. I don't know who it was. We paid him a fortune. I'm here. What's up, family? Hot doggers. Greg Bruce in the house. Thanks for being here. Snap dogs rock. Check out Crazy Dogs out on Facebook. That's right. Let's see. I'm just making sure I don't miss anything. Jeff, that's for sure. 80 dogs for 20 bucks. Yep. Let's see. Lake Lure. Yep. That's one of the lakes that's real good. Thinking about going full-time vendor, been doing part-time 2 years, making about $1,800 a month. Absolutely, John. Absolutely. But you're the one that has to, you know your finances, you know your budget, you know what you're capable of. And after 2 years, you definitely have a good handle on the business. You know where you can increase profits and where you could cut back hours and the right places to be at this point. So, yeah. Let's see. It's not hard getting inspired. Make your cart is up to the standards that your health department standards. Right. Hey guys, we finally started a Facebook page. Please go like it. Big D's Dogs. Dale, put the link to your page here. Put it in the comments. Okay. And that way people can go find it, because it is hard hitting that search thing on Facebook. You put in Big D's Dogs and they're giving you some dog outfit in Germany that breeds German shepherds for the police. And, let's see. LOL. That's true. Started with a 15-year-old all American. See, great info, Ben. Take the cart to the local machine shop. I would take him if he were close to me. That's right. Warren, would fix your cart for you. I'm scared to cook hot dogs for a living because I love hot dogs and I don't want to get tired of them. I think that goes with anything, but it depends on how you change it up. My favorite part of vending, besides the money, okay, is the people, is getting to interact and talk to people and have fun and enjoy it. Robbie says, I did the members mark, but Keith from Snap Dogs changed my mind with the tattoos on the dogs. I had to be different, curl the dogs. People love it. And I already told y'all need to check out Robbie and follow him. And if you're interested in Snap Dogs, Robbie can give you more information on that. You can also Google them. And if you're in the group, though, don't buy yet, because we should have a deal for the members. Let's see. Yes, Snap Dogs are awesome. They say beef and hot, that magical appear when heated up. I think they say Snap, too. They do. They've got some that say Snap Dog. Robbie Miller says hot, says 10 to 1 beef, and then Snap Dogs, too. Yep. What do you pay for 10 pounds of Snap Dogs, though? Let's see. Doing corn. Doing corn for Corn Fest, Babs. Brilliant. Smart, smart, smart. Yes. Y'all got a lot of festivals coming up. Need to be doing stuff for those festivals. Need to be actively pursuing corn mazes, haunted house things. Be looking at that, because you can get some good gigs. We had vendors last year. There was some vendors made over $4,000 in a 2-night deal at a haunted house. Oh, y'all, Heather put up the info, the link in the comments on the events. If you need help with that, now you don't even have to go search it. We have a vegan hot dog cart that does those and also do carrots and dogs. They seem to do pretty well for them. Anyone ever thought about a flatbread hot dog? Those things never have the bottom fall out. That's a great idea, Robbie. I have seen those. I've seen the pita ones, and I've even seen the pita pocket ones. It's smart, the thicker. That's why Jason uses the thicker, you know, the loaf bun. It's a thicker, denser bread, and still heats up nice, holds up the steam, but you can soak it up with some condiments. It's just awesome. Walk the dog is in the house. All right. I might need a treadmill when I sell hot dogs. You might do it. Babs grew corn had me one of the corn rows so good. Anyway, y'all, James says, keep teaching us, you rocking tonight. Thank you, James. I enjoyed this. I hope you did too. I'm sorry it went so long. We try to keep it to about 30 minutes, but we're at 40. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope you got some value out of it, and I'll see y'all. Corey just said, Vendors United has a great group of people, a family. Corey's got old doggies. Y'all need to check it out. I'm glad y'all are here. I love you, and I'll see you sometime tomorrow, I'm sure.